Good morning, everybody. This is Biji Philip. Today we are going to learn English grammar, direct and indirect speech. That is reported speech. Students, there are two ways in which we can report what a person says. For example, Ram said, I'm going to Kerala this evening. Otherwise, Ram said that he was going to Kerala that evening. See, in the first case, we actually caught the words of the speaker Ram. This is called direct speech. But in the second sentence, we do not caught the actual words of the speaker. We only report what the speaker said. This is called a reported speech or indirect speech. For example, say, says, ask, all these are in present tense. These are reporting verb. And let us see the past tense of these. Say, said, says, told, ask, asked. We can use this as a reporting verb. If the reporting verb is in the present tense or future tense, there is usually no change in the tense of reported verb. Okay, let's see the example. She says, I am feeling hungry. This is direct speech. Then let's see how we can write in indirect speech. She says that she is feeling hungry. See the difference between these two sentences. See, she says. So the reporting verb is in present tense. So we cannot change this. She says, then we add that. I am feeling hungry, there what we have written, she is feeling hungry. I is the pronoun. Who says? She says. So we have to say, she is feeling hungry. Here we did not change the reporting verb. Why? Because it is in present tense. If the reporting verb is in the present tense or in future tense, we should not change. Only we have to change the pronouns. Okay, clear? Let's move on to the next slide. Now see, if the reporting verb is in the past tense, statement containing historical event, universal truth or habitual action, there is no change in the tense. For example, she said, India became independent in 1947. Clear? Let's see the indirect speech. She said that India became independent in 1947. Here we did not change the reporting verb because this is historical event. We only add that. Okay, clear? Another example. Ram said, the sun rises in the east. This is the direct speech. Now let's see how we will write in the same sentence in indirect speech. Ram said that the sun rises in the east, because this is universal truth. Only we add that. Okay, rest of the things are the same. Now let's see one habitual action. Sita said, I usually sleep early. Sita said that she usually sleeps early. See, here we change the pronoun. I become she and we added that, and sleep becomes sleeps because she. So we have to use yes form of the verb sleeps. Okay, clear children? What is the difference between these two sentences? First one, direct speech. See, look at the example. She said, I am thirsty now. What is the indirect speech? She said that she was thirsty then. Now, let's see the difference between these two sentences. See, the first sentence, the exact words of the speaker are put within the inverted commas or quotation marks. But in the second sentence, the comma after the reporting verb and the quotation marks are removed. You know that the first sentence, she said comma, then inverted comma, I am thirsty now. Then inverted comma, closed, full stop. But see the second sentence, we removed after said, the comma is also removed. And after that, both the inverted commas are removed. Next, we put a comma after the reporting verb. See, she said comma. Okay. Then, the quoted words begin with the capital letter. First case, I am thirsty. I should be in capital letter. And then we have to put full stop or question mark. Whatever is the question, like that we have to put question mark. Otherwise, full stop. Then you have to close the inverted commas. But here we should add in the indirect speech, what we have to do? We should add the conjunction that. Okay, after the reporting verb, we have to add the conjunction that. Then, see, the pronoun I is changed into she. Then, the verb am is changed into was. Then, last, the adverb now is changed to then. These changes we have done in indirect speech. Okay, clear students? Let's move on. Let's see some examples how we are going to change from direct speech to indirect speech. This becomes that. If in the direct speech this is there, in the reported speech we have to write that. This becomes that. These become those. Now become then. Here became there. Today, that day. Tomorrow, the next day. Or the following day. Yesterday, the previous day. Then, I, he or she. I became he or she. Me, him or her. My, his or her. We, they. Us, them. Our, are, there. You, I, he or she. Students, you should write, note down all these things and you should learn all these changes also. You have to by heart it. Otherwise, you may forget. Okay? Let's move on to next slide. If the reporting verb is in the past tense, the verb in the reported speech changes as follows. For example, present symbol became past symbols, or present symbol becomes past symbol. Let's see one example. Direct speech, Reshma said, I hate fish. Okay, this is symbol present tense. I hate fish. Then the answer will be past in past symbol. So Reshma said that she, I become she hated. Past tense of hate is hated. Fish, sorry, meat I have written over here. She hated fish, whatever it is, fish or meat, whatever it is. Otherwise, I hate fish, I hate vegetables, I hate meat. Then you have to write, she hated meat, vegetables, fruits, fish, whatever it is. Okay, clear? Next case, present continuous becomes past continuous. Reena said, I am writing a letter. This is present continuous tense. Then let's see the answer in indirect speech. Reena said that she was writing a letter. I became she. Am become was. Then no other change. Conjunction, we add that, then she become, I become she, and am become was. Okay. Next, present perfect becomes past perfect. Example, Rinku said, I have completed my homework. I have completed, present perfect tense. Then it is in indirect speech. Rinku said that she had completed her homework. I have, that is she had, past perfect. She had completed my homework, means her homework. Clear, students? Next, present perfect continuous becomes past perfect continuous tense. Example, Rama said, I have been waiting for you. I have been waiting for you. Rama said that she had been waiting for him. Okay? Understood? We simply changed the tense. Okay, now past simple becomes past perfect. Here you have to remember. See, Reshma said, I wrote a letter. This is in simple past. I wrote a letter. The answer become past perfect tense. Reshma said that she had written a letter. See, I wrote a letter. She had written a letter. Okay, you should remember this. This rule, simple past become past perfect tense. Now, past continuous become past perfect continuous. Example, the student said, we were coming from school. What is the tense? Past continuous tense. This indirect speech, let us see, that will be in past perfect continuous tense. The student said that we become they. They had been coming from school. The student said that they had been coming from school. We become they. Then where coming become past perfect continuous tense, that is had been coming. Then no other change from school. Now future tense become conditional or should or would we have to use. For example, Reshma said, I shall come tomorrow. Then the answer is Reshma said that she would come the next day. Tomorrow become the next day. She shall, she would or should, you can use. She would come the next day. Okay, clear? Now, let's see imperative sentence. The reporting verb is changed to ordered, asked, requested or advised. Imperative sentence, you know that there is no subject. In the reported speech, the verb changed into infinitive. That you should always remember. Example, the master said to his servant, bring me a glass of water. See, bring me a glass of water. This is imperative sentence. So your answer should begin with the infinitive. Okay. So the master ordered his servant. Master said to his servant, that means master always order. So the master ordered his servant to bring him a glass of water. Another one. Reshma said to her friend, please close the door. So here please, that means it is a request. So Reshma requested her friend to close the door. Okay, clear, students? This is the case of imperative sentence. Now let's see the exclamatory sentence. the reporting verb is changed to exclaimed or wished or prayed. And we have to drop the exclamation mark. First one, direct speech. Maya said, "What a beautiful flower it is." This is an exclamatory sentence. What a beautiful flower it is. At first, we have to change the exclamatory sentence into a statement. So, the answer is in direct speech. Maya said, "It's a very beautiful flower." So, the exclamatory sentence is changed into a simple statement. It's a very beautiful flower. Now, you can make it into indirect speech. Maya exclaimed that, it become that. That was a very beautiful flower. Clear, students? Okay. Now, let's see interrogative sentence. The reporting verb is changed to asked or inquired because this is question. The question mark at the end is changed into full stop. Let's see first case of WH question. A question word like what, which, when, why, how, etc. In the reporting speech also begins with the same question word. Here also we have to start with the same question word. Okay. Now, let's see examples. Maya said to the boy, "What are you doing?" Then, indirect speech, Maya asked the boy, what is the WH question? What he was doing. What are you doing become what he was doing. Okay. Another one, Rohan said, "How is your father?" Rohan inquired, this is an inquiry, "How is your father?" So, Rohan inquired how his father was, full stop. Okay. And in the first case also, Maya said to the boy, "What are you doing?" Maya asked the boy what he was doing. You have to put full stop, not question mark. Okay. Second case, Rohan said, "How is your father?" So, Rohan inquired how my father was, because Rohan is asking me. Okay. How is your father? He is asking me, "How is your father?" So, I have to answer him that I should tell somebody like this. Rohan inquired how my father was. Okay, clear, students? Now, yes or no type questions. If the question begins with the verb like is, are, do, will, you know that all the yes or no type questions are can, etc. The reported speech begins with the E for whether. But along with the WH question, you have to use that particular WH word. But here, if the question is yes or no type question, you have to ask if or whether. We have to use if or whether. Example, Mary said, "Did you meet Anil?" Yes or no? The answer will be yes or no. So, how it will write in indirect speech? Mary asked whether I had met Anil. Okay. Whether I had met Anil. And you have to put full stop. Another one. The mother said to the son, "Are you studying English?" The mother asked the son, if or whether we can use. Whether he was studying English or if he was studying English. Clear, students? Understood, no? Okay, thank you, children.